Well, tomorrow is 2019. But I was just thinking, as I sit here this evening, I just thought ever since the birth and death of Jesus, which happened, of course, as the years are to commemorate on the Gregorian calendar, it's 2,099 years ago that Christ was born. And really, what have we learned as humans in the time since then? And not the Old Testament is all very difficult because of the fact that God didn't come down to earth as Christ. But what have we actually learned? We still have wars. We still hate each other. I mean, there are things that are good as well, but there's really the fault of man is that man just cannot become a perfect species, cannot become like God, because we have sin. We have this sin that separates us. And the sin also separates us from each other. So when we actually try to help each other or try to do good for each other, we can't because of the sin in us, unless you really are a committed Christian. And you really accept Jesus and you love and follow him fully. You just can't really bring yourself to repent of the sin enough to. And I mean, I must admit I'm totally ignorant, okay? I'm a person that's not at all I don't consider myself to be worldly because I don't want to be, but I consider myself a child of God. I might be judged. I don't know how God will judge me. I might go to hell. Who knows? But I really, really, really feel concerned for humanity. You know, I've spoken to numerous younger men that say to me, "Oh, that they're gods, and that there's other ways to come to God." Okay, well. Let's look at this in detail, okay? How else can you come to God? In the other religions, there's never been a God that has come, there's never been a man that came down from God to live amongst us the 33 years of his life for us to be saved from this dreadful disease called sin that is in us. Other religions, Islam, for example, Buddhism, what are the other ones? The other ones that you can think of, Hindu, they all have gods, but the God didn't die for us, and he didn't rise again, which is what Jesus did. You know, God speaks in the commandments about idolatry. He speaks and warns us in the Ten Commandments that that thou shalt not have other gods, nor carve an image of thyself. But yet the younger people still don't want to listen. And this is the problem with humanity. The real problem with humanity is that we have this disease called sin, which causes our downfall all the time. But it's just too easy. And that's why it's so hard in the world for us to really, really have strong and meaningful friendships and connections and love in God's image as what God designed us to be, because we are separated from God. We're separated from Him. And the sin separates us from Him. And us from each other, because we're in the world controlled by Satan, and that's the sad reality that we are actually in. And all the lies and the deception, especially that's peddled from various channels, that's peddled for the truth isn't the truth. It might be to the world. Worldly context, it might be. But what does the Bible and the scriptures say about it? God is the truth and the way. Jesus told us that he is the way, the life, and the truth. I mean, it's as clear as day and night. There's no other way to come to God. You can't come to God through a tree. You can't come to God through meditation. You can sort of find peace in meditation, but you can't come to God through meditation. Jesus is the only way that we can come to God. And the Bible tells us that. And yet, you know, there's a passage in the Bible that says, the God of this world has blinded the minds and pierced their hearts, I think it is. And that is exactly what's happened. So many are lost. I think in 2019 years of human evolution, I don't think man has really achieved very much at all. I think that the world is continually facing wars, hate, and all other sorts of issues because of the fact of sin. And, you know, the Bible says it to us in Romans 6:23, for the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is, or the free gift of God is eternal life through Christ Jesus our Lord. But, you know, it's just really, I just think that in my own way, that the younger people are deceived. They just follow and listen to the devil. The devil gives them what they want. Just go and spend, you know, make money. Go out and talk about yourself. Become your own God. Just follow your own instincts. But the thing that's sad about that is that there's the soul is what suffers because being made in the image of God, when those that make themselves into gods are only separating themselves from our Creator. We didn't design ourselves. We didn't come here of our own selves. We think only in the worldly dimension all the time. We didn't ask for ourselves to be born, and we don't choose when we die. But to the young men that say, I'm a God, there's other ways to God, you have to ask yourself those questions. If you're a God, how did you get yourself here? Also, you know, how can you explain your existence and your the conscience that you have? All that reasoning from the world, in the worldly sense, it has to have justification from the sense of God, because God is the creator. God put man on the earth, and that's what the planet says. God put man on the earth. And all I can say for you younger men who think you're gods and think that also that you're but there's other ways to God, I'd say that you're really following the path of Satan. And I really pray for you. I pray for your souls. Because really, you're going in the wrong path, as Jesus told us, is the great teacher and the man and of God. He told us. And you choose to really just not listen. All one can really do is pray for you. But as 2019 approaches, I know that my life on this planet is short. I know that I'm not a God. I know that I'm created in God's image. I know that I have so much to offer. I know that I have good and bad points. But I really, really do think that really you need to wake up, start to realize that who it is you're actually serving. And I know, and I will say to you in my life that I will always submit to Christ, even in the rough times, or even if my life depended on it, I would. But I don't know where you stand. Thanks very much for watching.